Good morning, students. Today we are going to discuss our topic, nutrition in human beings. Human digestive system. The nutrition in human beings is taking place through the human digestive system. Human digestive system consists of alimentary canal and its associated glands. The various organs of the human digestive system are in sequence: mouth, esophagus, or you can say food pipe, stomach, small intestine and large intestine. These are the organs which are helping in the digestion of the food. First, digestion starts with the mouth. After that, it goes into the food pipe, that is esophagus. From the esophagus, it is coming into the stomach, then small intestine, and then in the large intestine. These are the organs which are associated with the human digestive system. Now we will talk about the glands which are associated with the digestive system. There are three glands which are associated with the human digestive system. First gland is salivary gland. Second gland is liver, and third is pancreas. The human alimentary canal runs from the mouth to the anus. From the mouth to the anus, human alimentary canal runs. It is of 9 meter in long. It is of 9 meter long tube. The duct of the duct means opening. The opening of the gland opens into the alimentary canal and pour the secretion of digestive juices into the alimentary canal. Steps of digestion we are going to discuss one by one. First is ingestion, second is digestion, and third is absorption, fourth is assimilation, and last is ejection. Now we are going to discuss one. Now here one diagram for the human digestive system. This diagram shows the human digestive system. Now we are going to discuss this diagram, human digestive system. Now digestion starts from the mouth. This mouth cavity is called buccal cavity. It contains teeth, tongue, salivary glands. So what is the function of the teeth? Teeth used to cut the food into small pieces, helps in chewing and grinding the food particles. After that, salivary glands. Salivary glands are also present in our mouth. They produce saliva. And one tongue is also present in our food, that in our mouth. Tongue mixes the food with the saliva, and saliva is a watery liquid with substance which moist and lubricate the food. Salivary glands helps in digestion by secreting enzymes. Human saliva contains an enzyme called salivary amylase, which digests the starch into the sugar. So what is the function of the saliva, that is amylase, which is salivary amylase? It digests starch into the sugar, or you can say it converts starch into sugar. So now we are going to discuss all these parts one by one. We have discussed mouth and tongue function. So I will repeat. Mouth is a buccal cavity and digestion starts with the mouth. It contains teeth, tongue, salivary glands. Teeth helps to cut and the food into small pieces and chew it and grind it. Then salivary gland produces saliva, and tongue mixes the food with saliva. Saliva is a watery substance which helps in moist the food and helps in the easy swallowing and lubricate the food. And salivary glands also helping in digestion by giving the enzymes, by secreting the enzymes. Salivary gland secrete one enzyme, that is salivary amylase, which digest the starch into the sugar. Now food remains short time in the mouth. Food remains short time in the mouth. The slightly digested food in the mouth is swallowed by tongue and goes down the food pipe and carries to the stomach. The walls of the food pipe have sphincter muscle which contract and relax regularly. This movement of contracting and expanding, relaxing is called peristaltic movement of the food pipe. This the movement of the contraction and relaxation of the walls of the food pipe is called peristaltic movement. This movement pushes the food into the stomach, and this movement is very important movement, and this movement pushes the food down into the stomach. And the stomach is a J-shaped organ present in the left side of the abdomen, mainly on left side of the abdomen. Food is churned there in the stomach for 3 hours. That means food remains in the stomach for 3 hours. Within that, food is churned fully. Now the food break down and form a semi-solid paste. Glands are present in the walls of the small stomach and secrete gastric juices. Glands which are present in the walls of the stomach secrete gastric juices. These gastric juices contains 3 substances. What are the 3 substances? Are hydrochloric acid, enzyme, pepsin and mucus. These are the 3 juices with 3 substances having consisting. So first is hydrochloric acid, second is enzyme pepsin, and third is mucus. In acidic medium, the enzyme pepsin starts the digestion of the proteins present in the food to smaller molecules. Protein digestion starts in the stomach, and pepsin is the only active in the presence of the acid. If there is acid present in the stomach, then only the pepsin enzyme will act on the food. Hydrochloric acid makes medium of gastric juices acidic, so pepsin can digest proteins properly. Hydrochloric acid also kills bacteria of the food. So that means hydrochloric acid plays a 2 functions. First, it makes the medium of the gastric juices acidic so that pepsin enzyme can act properly on the protein and digest it properly. Second function of the hydrochloric acid is to kill the bacteria of the food. That means while we are taking the food, some bacteria enters into the stomach, and that bacteria are killed by this gas, hydrochloric acid. The mucus helps. Third one is mucus. Mucus helps to protect the stomach wall from its own secretion of hydrochloric acid. Hydrochloric acid एक तेजाब होता है. तेजाब से बचाता है हमें म्यूकस. वॉल्स ऑफ द स्टोमक आर प्रोटेक्टेड बाय दिस म्यूकस. इफ द म्यूकस इज नॉट सेक्रेटेड, एक्सियल एसिड विल कॉज द एरोजन ऑफ इनर लाइनिंग ऑफ द स्टोमक, लीडिंग टू द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ द अल्सर्स इन द स्टोमक. So why ulcers come or exist in the stomach? Because the mucus is not performing its function properly. The partial digested food goes from the stomach into the small intestine. The exit of the food from the stomach is regulated by the sphincter muscle, which releases it in small amount into the small intestine. Small intestine is the largest part of the food pipe. Its mean length is 6.5 meter long in adult human. In adult man, its length is 6.5 meter. And small intestine is called small. Why it is called small? Because it is very narrow. So it is calling the small intestine. It is arranged in the form of coil in our belly. Small intestine is like a coil in our belly. herbivore animals like cow, which are eating grasses. They need longer small intestine to allow the cellulose present in the grass to be digested completely. So carnivores need small intestine because meat, they are eating meat, and meat is easily digested by it. So they need small intestine. The small intestine in human beings is the site of complete digestion of food like carbohydrates, proteins, and fat. Small intestine receives the secretion of the two gastric glands. First is liver and then is pancreas. Liver secretes bile juice, which is greenish yellow liquid made in the liver and stored in the gallbladder. Where this bile juice is stored? In the gallbladder it is stored. Bile is alkaline, contains salts which helps to emulsify or break fats present in the food. And what is the function of the bile? It exists in two functions. First function is that bile makes the food acidic, on which pancreatic enzyme acts. Pancreatic enzyme acts only when the food is acidic, and food is made acidic by the bile. Second function of the bile is bile salt break the fat present in the food into small globules, which makes easy for the enzymes to act on it and digest them properly. Pancreas is a large gland. Pancreas secrete pancreatic juice, which contains digestive enzymes like pancreatic amylase, trypsin, and lipase. So now, what the role of these enzymes we are going to discuss? So first enzyme is amylase. It breaks down the starch. Amylase breaks down the starch. Second enzyme is trypsin, which digests the protein. Third enzyme is lipase, which break down the emulsified fat. That means amylase break the starch, trypsin digest the protein, and lipase break down the emulsified fat. The walls of the small intestine contains glands which secrete intestine juice. The intestine juice contains a large number of enzymes which complete the digestion of complex carbohydrate into glucose, proteins into amino acids, and fats into fatty acids and glycerols. Glucose, amino acids, fatty acids, and glycerol are small water-soluble molecules. Chemical digestion is brought by biological catalyst called enzymes. After digestion, the molecules of food goes into our blood. This is called absorption. Small intestine is the main region for the absorption of the digested food. The inner surface of small intestine has millions of tiny finger-like projection called villi. Villi is a finger-like projection. It helps in increasing the surface area for the absorption of the digested food. Digested food. Now this food goes into blood. The blood carries digested and dissolved food to all parts of the body, where it comes assimilated as the parts of the cells. This assimilated food is used by body cells for getting energy, growth, repair of food. The energy is released by oxidation of assimilated food in cells during the respiration process. As the part of the food which we eat cannot be digested by our body,
sorry, the undigested food can be absorbed in small intestine. So undigested food passes from small intestine into large intestine. The walls of large intestine absorbs most of the water from the undigested food. So what is the function of the large intestine? To absorb most of the water from the undigested food. This food becomes solid. Rectum is the last part of the large intestine. Rectum stores this undigested food for some time. This undigested food is passed out as toilet through the anus. The act of expelling the feces is called egestion. That means it removes the waste product from the body. This process is called egestion. That means food is thrown out. The exit of the feces is controlled by the anal sphincter. This is all about the process of digestion in the human beings. So now I have given some of the questions, that means assignment for you, my dear students. You have to work out all these questions and send me the answers through the chat box. So first question, what moves the food in digestive organs? What moves the food in the digestive organs? Second question, what is the other name of food pipe? Third question, what is the role of HCl, that means hydrochloric acid, in the stomach? Fourth question, what is the function of the trypsin? Now fifth question is, match the following: trypsin, amylase, bile juice and pepsin. You are going to match with this. So here is five questions for you. Please work out all these questions and send me so that I can understood whether you have understood this chapter, what I have taught you easily. If any inquiry you are having to raise, so please give me a check, or you can make your doubt clear through the chat box. You can call me, you can write a message to me so that I can explain the topic once again. Thank you.